Hello, everybody. Today on Tranquil Journeys ASMR, we are going to be cleaning my rifle. This is a Swiss K31. As the name implies, this rifle comes from Switzerland, and this particular rifle was manufactured in 1953. So, this thing is a relic from the past, but it's also a very piece of history, a very important piece of history, because it is the last bolt-action rifle in service by the Swiss military, and one of the last bolt-action rifles in service with the Western military in the world. This is an extremely finely made rifle. They were widely known for their accuracy, their craftsmanship, and also the uniqueness of their action, which I will get into later. So, without too much further ado, let's begin with disassembling the rifle, and from there we will go into cleaning. So, let me remove the screwdriver I was using to prop that up as a display piece. So, first things first, when you're disassembling this rifle, is to move the magazine located here. This is a magazine that holds 6 rounds. It's fairly robust for being such a low capacity. Also makes a fun sound. We'll set that aside. We don't need to clean that unless there's gunk in it. And there isn't today. Next thing to do with any gun is to make sure that we check to see that the chamber is not loaded. So, can't really see on camera, but there is no cartridge in the chamber, so this gun is safe. So, we will then remove the bolt by pressing down on this lever and pulling the bolt out. So here we have the K31 bolt. As you can see, it's an interesting syringe-looking implement, and it's very complicated piece of machinery. It's incredibly fine, and if I get a close-up, look at the mirror polish and shine on that, even after almost 70 years. It's incredible how well these were made. So, we're going to begin by disassembling and cleaning the bolt. As you can see, there is a cam track in the bolt that runs along the side right here. This is because the bolt itself rotates when you pull the handle in one direction. So in that way, you don't have to turn a handle and load it. You simply pull back and this cam track does the rest. So here's how we disassemble the K31 bolt in order to clean it. First, we begin by taking this firing pin, pulling it out of its track, which allows us to rotate the bolt freely, and remove the handle. After that, we put it back into the fire. Oh, excuse me, no, we don't. We keep it there. Until that happens. So at the right moment, the whole thing separates. We have the bolt head itself, which has the spring-loaded extractor, and this is where the cartridge rests. And this is, there's not a proper name for it, but this is a bolt sleeve, or bolt housing, if you will, you can see it's mostly just a hollow tube. And that's where the bolt rides. And these are the two locking lugs that lock into the barrel. After that, it really begins to look like a syringe. At this point, then we put the firing pin back into firing position. And we simply pull down on this spring right here and take the firing pin off. There's the spring. There's the firing pin. And these two parts come out. It's the firing pin key and also the safety. This is the rear housing for the firing pin. So let's begin our cleaning with the pieces of the bolt, because that's the easiest part. Take some Outers Nitro Solvent Gun Cleaner. Shake it up nice and good. And we're going to begin by cleaning the bolt head. Get that nice and soaked. We're going to take a brass brush and begin scrubbing it. Getting every crook and cranny. Set that aside for now. Then the bolt housing. This doesn't experience much gunpowder when the cartridge fires, so you just need to give this a light brushing. Sort of clean the cam track so that the bolt doesn't get stuck when you're trying to cycle the action. And always be sure to clean the locking lugs just in case, because that's how the gun safely locks into the barrel, and you want to make sure that there's nothing obstructing it from locking to prevent any kind of damage occurring. Let's put that away. We'll take the firing pin, and we'll do a light scrubbing on it as well. We want to make sure there's no gunk on the firing pin so that it doesn't get stuck in the bolt housing or the firing pin hole. Because the way this works is that the firing pin comes out just a little bit right there, you can see it. You want to make sure that it won't ever get stuck in that small hole and prevent the cartridge from being fired. On the operating handle, very light scrubbing with a plastic brush, because you don't want to ruin the glue finish on this. To remove any dust and debris. A light spray for the spring. No scrubbing is necessary. And finally, this. Very light scrubbing. Just to remove any dirt or debris. Not necessarily any gunpowder. Alright. So, I'm actually gonna steal one of these real quick. And wipe down our parts. There's the bolt body. Next to the firing pin. Next, we will have the bolt. Spring, just give it a nice squeeze, make sure there's no leftover solvent. Wipe down the operating or charging handle. And rub down this. Remove all as much as you can of that solvent, although it does act as a lubricant, so having a little bit in there certainly isn't a bad thing. Alright, so That takes care of the bolt. Now we are going to remove the receiver from the wooden housing to make it easier to clean the barrel, especially on camera. So I'm going to turn this upside down and remove these two screws. These screws affix the receiver into the wooden stock. And provide strength and support when firing. After that, we're going to move up to the front of the gun and remove these two barrel bands. We're gonna move the last one first. Oops. This is also the mounting point for the bayonet and stacking hook. This lug right here is the bayonet mounting point. Knife slides over there. And this hook is for stacking three rifles together in a teepee pyramid, teepee style. Such as when a company is making camp somewhere in the wilderness, you would have three men stack their rifles together so that in a moment's notice they can all grab their rifles and respond to a threat in the night or a sudden marching order. We'll slide this one off. After that, top handguard comes off, put this over there, and then the receiver simply lifts out of the gun, lifts out of the stock. Put this off camera for now. So here we have the gun itself, which is this barrel and contraption on the back. This is what the gun is. And here's a close-up of the trigger mechanism. So we're going to begin cleaning the barrel. And to do this, we're going to assemble a cleaning rod. Excuse the headphone wire in there. So, we're going to begin by assembling this rod. Make sure that the rod is at least a few inches longer than the barrel, so that way we have clearance to put use our hand. A couple more segments here. Measure that again and compare it to the length of the barrel. So that's about 4 inches past the barrel, so that's a good length for me. So now we add the cleaning brush, which in this case is going to be a medium length. And lastly, we had a thread adapter for the brush. All right. So, with our brush assembled, we will now begin the cleaning of the barrel. So we're going to use this tube on the applicator here, press it into the chamber, and squeeze. Make sure the inside of the barrel is nice and soaked, and then we will, we're going to turn this around and begin cleaning the barrel. I'm going to push it all the way through and bring it back out and push it through and bring it back out. And you want to do this about 5 times. So now you remove your brush. You get your swab adapter. Remove the adapter, then add the swab adapter. Grab a fresh swab, thread it through, make sure it's even on both sides, and then push it through the barrel. Get up all that gum solvent and burnt powder. And then you inspect it to see how much residue is on there. So, I haven't shot this gun in a little while, and last time I did, I cleaned it pretty thoroughly, so there isn't a whole lot in there, but I'm going to do it a couple more times anyway. Place that over there. Remove your swab adapter. Re-add the brush adapter. And then re-add the brush. We're going to give the rifle another spritzing with the gun solvent. And once more. And we're going to do it a little smarter this time. Remove both at once. And grab the swab piece. Another fresh swab, threading it through the eyelet. And once more, back and forth in the barrel. And we can see that it is now mostly just residue from gun cleaner. So normally you'd want to scrub your barrel at least a couple more times, but for brevity's sake, I won't have you endure that. So now the barrel is nice and clean. Make sure to always disassemble your tools. And now, we will begin reassembling the rifle. Make sure my hands are wiped free of any solvent, of course. Let's begin by placing it back into the stock. Although, there is one thing that I want to show you before I place it back in the stock, and that lies under the butt pad. So, one of the unique features of the Swiss Army is that, at least in 1953, every male over the age of 18 was considered part of the national militia. Had to serve a mandatory, I believe it's 1 to 2 years in the military, and after his active duty service, he maintained a rifle, ammunition, and all sorts of other armaments in his own home, so that if anything should happen, the entire male population can be called on to defend the country. And because these rifles were issued to people in their homes, they all came with a unique identifying tag underneath the butt plate, which identified the owner. This is one of the really, really cool things about this gun. So here we have an identifying address of the man who originally owned this rifle. He lived in Zurich. Now, I'm not sure if this is a name or a place. Zeughaus. It's something house. It's either a place or a name, but regardless, we can pin this rifle to having been owned by someone in Zurich in 1953. And I think that is just a absolutely incredible little piece of history that gives the rifle so much more personality and a feeling of history to it. So we're going to reassemble that part now. And I will cut ahead. Okay, with the butt pad reassembled, let's now place the receiver back into the stock. Let's go ahead and screws. You always want to make sure your screws are of even tightness, otherwise it could change the way the receiver is set into the stock, and that can actually affect your point of impact from where you aim, which means your sights are not aligned with where the bullets are actually going, which is not desirable. Now we'll place the top of the handguard back on. The first barrel turned on. Requires a bit of finesse because you have to seat the spring on the stock. But from there, it's nice and easy. And we'll finish tightening that once we have the second barrel band on. Open the clamp. Now the stock is reassembled and the gun is seated nice and comfy, just like you are, hopefully. Now we begin the reassembly of the bolt. Normally I would coat each of these parts in lubricant, but I don't want to do that because I'm going to do a much more thorough job off camera before I put it back in the safe. So, this is just for demonstration purposes. So, reassembly of the bolt is the exact opposite of disassembly. So, begin with the barrel sleeve and the bolt. Place them together and make sure that these notches are lined up just like that. You can see that. Make sure those are lined up. From there, we're going to reassemble the firing pin and firing pin key. In fact, look at that, it looks just exactly like a key and a lock. It's incredible. Put the spring over the key. This part's a little difficult. So I need to compress this spring and slip this over the notch. I'll do this off camera. Because unfortunately, I have to press this against my hip. There we go. As you can see, there's a T-section that it fits into. So now, with this, I'm going to put it in the reassembly position of the key. And then we're going to turn until they slide together. There we go. And then we're going to assemble that so that the cam track is on the right, which lines up with the slot for the charging handle. Put the charging handle in. Nice and easy, it found the groove. Everything is assembled, and now we lock it with the key. There. And now, the easy part, simply line up the holes and gently push it in. And lock it. And be sure to drop the firing pin by putting your thumb against the spring, pulling the trigger, and releasing. Last step, insert the magazine. And there you have it, a clean K31, ready for your next day at the range. Thank you for joining me in this nice, relaxing gun cleaning session. I hope you've enjoyed it, and I will see you next time.